Now, let's focus on the most interesting part of driverless AI, the predict button, which will bring us to a new window where all the action takes place. We are going to launch our first experiment, which means that we are going to generate a prediction using the dataset of our choice. In this case, we will use the credit score train dataset. Remember that we are interested in predicting whether a credit score is going to be good or bad based on the training data, the historical data provided to us by the business. By applying the same models from the training data to the test dataset, driverless AI makes sure that only the best models are going to be considered, because those ones will give us high prediction scores. If this is the first time launching an experiment, the following prompt will appear, asking if you want to take a tour. For a quick tour of the experiments page, you can select Yes. This will cover some of the following items: selecting a training dataset, a target column, or specifying a date or a time component in case you are dealing with a time series problem. This is a separate learning path that you can follow later on if interested. For the time being, please select Not Now, as for the most part, this learning path will cover what is mentioned during the tour. The experiment preview page will appear next. This preview page displays all the settings that driverless AI will use before launching an experiment. What I particularly like is the assistant button that you can find on the top right side of the experiment setup section. And this is because it presents an interactive tour for first-time users too. If you click on the assistant button to enable it, you will see yellow circles appearing around sections of the experiment page. You can click on them to get additional insights about the field, and you can navigate through the driverless AI interface while also using the previous and the next button. Let's click on the assistant button again to disable it. Please also note that whenever you hover over a section, you have a pop-up window that appears, which gives you a thorough explanation about that specific functionality. I am going to select the experiment type, and because our target variable is the categorical feature credit score, which contains only two labels, the experiment type is going to be supervised. The display name is optional. If this field is left blank, driverless AI will automatically generate a name for the experiment, which you can also rename later on from the experiments tab directly. Let's give the name baseline to our experiment, as we are not going to modify any of the options from the default settings just yet. The training dataset section is already completed, and it indicates the name of the dataset being used to create the experiment. The test dataset section uses the dataset on which the model generated from the training dataset will be tested. As a reminder, this testing dataset is not used during the model's training. Let's select the credit score test dataset for this particular field by clicking on the test dataset field and choosing the credit score test from the new window that appears. In the experiment setup, you can specify a couple of additional options: the validation dataset used for tuning the modeling pipeline, the fault column, which ensures that rows with the same value represent groups that should be kept together in the training, validation, or cross-validation datasets, the weight column, which indicates the observation weight if applicable. Rows with higher weights have thus higher importance. Dropped columns and the time column option, which provides a chronological order to our data and is currently set on off. Because we do not have any time dimension component in our dataset, it will stay as such, but please note that if you turn it on, you can access the time series functionalities of the driverless AI. Again, this is a subject treated in a separate learning path, so please make sure that you check out our H2O University learning platform in case you are interested. Except for the target column field, the other fields are optional, and we are not going to modify them for this first baseline experiment. Now, let's select the target column by clicking on the intermittent checkbox. A new window will appear, and if we scroll down, we can find our credit score feature. Please select it. Once this is done, there is a new world that opens to us with additional training settings. Let's explore them. Your experiment page should look similar to the one you see on the screen. These are further suggestions based on the selected trained dataset. Driverless AI has detected that our target column is a string type, which contains only two unique values. We have 80k values in total to train our model on, and the target frequency, meaning the credit score, which is bad, is around 23k, or 1/5 of our entire dataset.